Hello everyone, welcome to the Stock Trading Tutor channel. If you would like to create a free Demat account, click the link in the description and fill out your details. Now, let's look at the different terms used in mutual funds. Here are the terms we'll be looking at. Asset management company, that is AMC, asset allocation, corpus, compounding, load, net asset value, portfolio, and systematic investment plan. Let's look at asset management company, also known as AMC. An AMC is a company that manages the money of investors. The company pools all the money from different investors and invests in different securities based on the investment objectives of the mutual fund. An AMC doesn't just manage mutual funds, they also deal with pension plans and hedge funds. Next is asset allocation. Equities and bonds are two kinds of asset class. Every asset class in the market comes with a certain degree of risk. This is where asset allocation comes in. It is an investment strategy of spreading the investment amount across various asset classes in order to balance the risk level. There is no specific formula for the perfect asset allocation. It is entirely based on each investor's investment goals and risk appetite. Next is corpus. Corpus is defined as the total amount of money that is invested in a particular scheme by all investors. For example, imagine that there are 100 units in an equity fund. Each unit is worth rupees 10. The total corpus of the fund is now 1000 rupees. Now, if a couple of new investors invest another rupees 300 in the fund, the corpus would increase to 1300 rupees. Next term is compounding. Mutual funds offer returns to investors regularly. This can be on a monthly, quarterly, or yearly basis. The returns earned on the fund can be reinvested back into the fund by the investor. This way, even the interest starts to earn interest. This is known as compounding. Investors can earn much higher returns in the long term through the power of compounding. Next is load. Load is defined as the fee that an investor pays when he buys or sells a mutual fund. There are two types of loads, entry load and exit load. Entry load is the charge payable at the time of buying the units of a fund. Similarly, exit load is the charge payable at the time of selling a mutual fund. This charge is paid as a percentage of the investment amount. For instance, if you are investing 500 rupees in a mutual fund and the entry load is 5%, you have to pay 25 rupees as the load. Next is net asset value. Net asset value, or NAV, represents the value of a mutual fund. It gives you the value per share of the fund at any given point of time. The formula for NAV is as follows. NAV equals to the value of assets minus the value of liabilities whole divided by the number of units outstanding. The NAV of a fund is updated once per day. This is done at the end of the day's trading session. The NAV of a fund helps investors to analyze if the fund is overvalued or undervalued. This helps them to make better investment decisions. Next is portfolio. A portfolio is the total range of investments that are held by a particular investor. For example, if an investor has invested in 5 mutual funds, then these funds would constitute his portfolio. At the same time, if you have invested in a single fund, then your portfolio would consist of a single mutual fund. Investors try to have multiple funds in their portfolios for the sake of diversification. This is because in case of a particular fund fails in the market, then the returns from other funds can help compensate for the losses. This way you can avoid losing all your money when you invest. Next is systematic investment plan. A systematic investment plan, or SIP, is an investment technique. Here, investors can invest a specific amount of money on a regular period basis. This can be monthly, quarterly, or even annually. Each period, a fixed amount of money is used to buy a certain number of units in the mutual fund. The number of units can vary depending on the price of the fund. A higher price means lesser number of units, while a lower price means more number of units. Investing through SIPs is a great way to achieve investment discipline as well as high returns in the long term. Thank you for watching this video. For more videos on stock market and trading, please subscribe to this channel. If you would like to create a free Demat account, click the link in the description and fill out your details.